Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How was the day and how's business and all? So don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You can follow us on IG at ramat_posh_design, and kindly drop comments, like and share to friends. So now today we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to cut normal abaya. So this type of abaya, we have a cape on the neck, or how you used to call it, but it's just normal abaya. So the material, the fabrics, this thing that I'm using is you can use any fabrics for this design. You can use a plain fabric, you can use a flat fabric, depending on your choice. So what I'm using today is I'm using two trousers and cutter. The cutter is 11 inches. So a trouser is 45 inches, a yard is 36 inches. So what we're going to do now is we're going to be needing two trousers and cutter. So the first thing for me to do now is my fabric is always length 62, even more than sometimes. So I'm going to be removing my neck cape first. That will be the first thing I'm going to be doing. So I'll just remove it at the edge of the design of the fabric rather. So you can see the length. The length is very, very long. If I measure this length, it will be up to 62 or 64. So the only thing I'm going to do now, I'm going to remove 4 inches here. I'm going to move it in two. I'm going to remove two pieces of this. So after I remove two pieces of this, then we cannot proceed with our cutting. You can remove three if you want your abaya to have a belt, but if you don't want your abaya to have a fabric belt, you can remove just only two. So I'm going to be removing three. So I want my fabrics to be belt as well. So I'm going to tear this out now. And
the next thing for us to do now is to remove the body of our abaya. The measurement I'll be using for the body of my abaya will depend on the flatness of my client, but generally I do use one trouser and 23 inches for my measurement. And if your client is using hip of 15 inches, using waist of 30 inches and bust of 35 inches, what you're simply going to do is that you're going to take the biggest measurement out of the waist, the bust and the hip. The hip will be the biggest measurement if the hip is happened to be 15 inches. So you are going to remove the hip and you are going to add 30 inches to it, if in case the person that holds the abaya is a fat person. Hope I'm clear. So what I will be using today is one trouser which is 45 inches and 23 inches. That is what I will be removing. After I remove this, I'm going to fold it into four and watch for the next procedure we are going to
do. I'm done with the folding of my fabrics into four, as you can see. So this side is the side we are going to cut our neck. This side is the side where we are going to cut our hand. Do you understand me? So you can see this is the rough side that we are going to cut the neck. So I expect your fabrics to remain this, which you are going to use to cut your two ends, your abaya ends. So the next thing for us to do now is the back of my client is 15 inches. So I'm going to add 1/2 inches to that 15, making 15.5 inches, which means I'll be removing 8. I'll divide it by 2, which is 8, which is 7.5, or rather, sorry, 7.5. So you will divide your bag by 2 and add 1/2 inches allowance for the sewing allowance. So let me do that. So this is 7.5. I've already chalked out my 7.5. From my arm to the armhole is 7 inches, depending on how fat the person is. But if the person is my size or a little bit bigger than me, the person can use 7 inches downward. But if the person is very, very fat, you can use 10 inches, 11 inches, depending on the size of your client. So the bust I'll be using 13 inches for the bust. So, which means I'll remove 13 inches, which means my bust is 20, each fabric will be 26. So what I'll be removing directly is 13. So had it been your client bust is 40, we are going to add 10 inches, making 50. I'm going to divide 50 by 4, that is 12. So that's how I got my measurement. Your bust will determine the bust of your client. You add 10 inches to your bust, you divide it by 4, and you remove that. So I'll be removing 13 directly from this fabric. So this is my 13, and I will shape it out. I'll just shape it out. I'm not cutting it out at all. I just slant my shirt out a little bit. So as you can see, so that's all. You can see that I've not shaped it out. So I'm going to check out my neck. Remember, my neck is 3 inches. That is my constant measurement that I do use, and I think it's a general measurement as well. So this is my 13 inches, which means I will have a back and a front. So this should be your outcome, as you can see. So this should be your outcome. So now, the next thing for us to do now is we are going to trim out the 3 inches for the front. We are going to trim out this 3 inches for the front only. You can see the front is 2-piece, as you can see. We are going to trim out this 3 inches downward, and the back still remains the same. So let me show you a clear picture. A
clear picture of the outcome of the kimono. This is our armhole, this is our waistband. I didn't shape here at all. So this is the two front piece, as you can see it. So this is our back. So I'm going to cut out these 3 inches downward now, because remember, I'm going to cut it out downward. If you remember, we already removed 3 pieces for at the beginning of our class, 2 pieces for the neck and 1 piece for the belt. So I'm going to trim out the 3 inches for the neck now and see the outcome.
So as you can see, I've already trimmed this out. So we're going to replace it with the two we removed earlier from the video. So now guys, look at the outcome. I've already trimmed out the 3 inches. As you can see, I've already trimmed out the 3 inches. So we're going to replace it with the other three pieces we removed. Out of the 3 pieces, the 2 is for the neck and the other one is for the waist belt. So the next thing for us to do now is to cut the hand. The length of my hand I'm using is 24 inches, and let's begin cutting the hand. I've already folded my fabrics into 4. I'm going to cut. This will be the side of my hand and this will be the outer. So the armhole of the hand will determine the armhole of the dress you cut. So the armhole of my dress I cut is 11.5. So I'm going to measure 11.5 now, and I will chalk this out. After chalking it out, I'm going to measure out my hand length, which is 24 plus 1 inches, making 25 inches. So I'm going to chalk 25 inches out and I will connect it. I want my abaya hand to be very big. So that is why I'm not doing any shaping in the hand. So I'm already cutting the hand already. This should be your beautiful outcome for the hand. So this is my length, 25 plus 1 inches allowance. So that is all. These are the 3 pieces we removed earlier. Remember, I used 4 inches by the length of the fabrics. The length of my fabrics is like 64, 62, depending on how long your fabric is. So I'm going to use 2 pieces to turn out the neck, and the remaining 1 piece I'm going to use it for the belt. So this will come to the end of our class. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like, comment, share, practice this, send me videos. I'm going to do correction on it. Please kindly share my video to your friends. Follow me on IG at ramat_posh_design. Follow me on Facebook as well, Ramat Adebayo. I'm going to accept your friend request. Kindly like, subscribe. It's very, very important. Subscribe is not, you're not paying for it. Just click on subscribe and it's done. Thank you guys. Love you. Bye.